Good morning, children.
So, children, you know, in the case of green plants, most of the green plants are preparing their own food. You know, these green plants are preparing their food with the help of some non-living things. So, we call these non-living things as, in the case of, we can say that sunlight or water. Or carbon dioxide. These are the non-living things which are used by the plants to prepare their food. So when we are considering the case of green plants, they are producing their own food. So these green plants are commonly known as one name. What is that? Produces, we can say that. Produces. So green plants are known as what is that? Produces. They produce their own food with the help of non-living things like sunlight, water or carbon dioxide. So they are producing their food. So these green plants are known as producers. You know, when these plants are producing their food, sometimes they are producing extra food also. This extra food which is produced by these plants are storing on various parts of these plants in the form of fruit. Or in the form of seeds like that. So when we are considering the case of this extra food which is stored, for example, first we can say that some of the plants which are storing this extra food on their fruits, for example, in the case of a banana plant, we are obtaining banana from that plant. For example, in the case of a mango tree, we are obtaining mango from that. Like this way, we are obtaining various fruits from the plants. So which is actually food stored by these plants only. Then in certain plants we are obtaining this food in the form of a stem, you can see that stem, for example, in the case of sugarcane or in the case of potato. In this type of plants, their food they stored in the form of a stem only. In the case of a sugarcane or a potato, they are considered as an underground stem. So food is preserved on their stem. Then when we are considering the case of a certain other plants, you know, food is stored on their seeds only. Seeds, for example, in the case of a wheat or in the case of a rice. In all these cases, food is stored on their seeds only. Now, in certain other plants, you know, in the case of some other plants like cabbage or spinach, in that case, food is stored on their leaves only. For example, in the case of a spinach or in the case of a cabbage. So, their food is stored on their leaves only. In some other plants, you can see that, food is stored on their leaves. Leaves, that means that is a spinach or a cabbage. In some other plants, the food is stored on their roots. For example, in the case of radish, or in the case of carrot. In all these cases, the food is stored on their roots. Then we can consider the case of flower also. In certain plants, the food is stored on their flower. For example, in the case of a cauliflower. So in that case, we can see that the food is stored on their flower. That means in this way, plants are storing their food on various places in the form of a fruit or in the form of a stem or a seeds, a leaves or a roots and a flower. And you know, these are consumed by some other category. So for example, in the case of human beings, they are consume this type of food items which are stored by these plants on. Or in the case of animals. So we can say that in the case of animals or human beings, they are consuming this type of food items which are stored by these plants. So they are commonly known as what is that? Consumers. They are known as consumers. So they are consuming the food items which are stored by these plants. So they are commonly known as consumers. Here along with this, I want to say a small activity. You can see that. Here you can see that this is a grains only. You can see that this is a mung bean. You can see that mungs are there. You can see that I soaked this mung bean. You can see that it is soaked for one night, one overnight. I kept in water, and next day morning I drawn out this water and I kept it for some time. You can see that in this case there are some white substances are coming out from this type of substances. You can see that there are some white substances are coming out from this. See that small white substances are coming out from this. That means this mung is sprouted. You can see that there's a sprouting is taking place. So this type of sprouting is taking place in the case of a mungs. You know, this is we can use it as a good nutrient food. So we can use this in a raw form. After washing, we can use this it as a raw form, or after boiling, we can add some spices and we can consume this type of food items. Okay, thank you.